Hey guys, welcome one more time to Unfold Data Science brainstorming session. We have Dinesh and Hassan with me here, and one more person may join in sometime. But we will get started with the introduction of our team first for today's brainstorming session. And then I will show you what is that use case we are going to discuss and what are the different steps that we are going to discuss. So Hassan or Dinesh, anybody will chat and can introduce yourself first.
Hi guys, my name is Nanesh. I am from Visakhapatnam. I have post-graduated in Bodai College in the year 2018, and I am working as an Android developer in GCRS company, and my work experience is 2 years.
Okay, cool. Hassan, how about you?
Hi, my name is Mohammed Sindhisvi. I'm from Lucknow, Uttar Pradesh, and I'm currently working as an automation engineer in one of the leading MNCs. And I'm an aspiring data science enthusiast, which is looking for a career transition in data science.
Okay, cool. So let me share mine and show you what is the use case I plan to discuss today. Okay. Let me know once you are able to see my screen. Yes, are you able to see my screen?
Yes, sir.
Yes,
ma'am. Okay. So I go here, use case brainstorming. And this is the PPT. I kind of keep a generic format for this. Okay. So I have written here Amal Himalaya, or to whomever I send the request, Arpit, Ganesh, and Hassan. Use case brainstorming. So the problem statement that I'm going to talk about today is, this is one problem statement I have seen in my in some of my training experience, hence I'm talking this to you. So for example, there is a bank XYZ, okay? You can think of our ICICI or HDFC bank is interested in enhancing user experience. So when you log on to ICICI or HDFC bank, right, then there may be different things that you think can be better, right? There may be few things that you know, it might be coming to your mind that this can be better than this, okay? And what will happen if we do this? If we do this, then customer will be more attached to that bank, which means customer will be more longer a customer, or customer will be a happy customer. So what should not happen is, I will give you one example. Suppose I do some mutual funds, okay? And when I log into HDFC bank, then I want to quickly go to see my mutual fund report. Just an example I'm giving. And if it is difficult for me to go to that mutual fund tab or, you know, see my report, that doesn't good. That is not a good user experience. Just an example. So as a data science person or as a data science team, me and you, three, four of us, what support we can provide or how we can improve the user experience, okay? So that is what we are going to discuss today, and what kind of data we will collect, what kind of use case we can do, what kind of hypothesis we can create, what kind of experience we can improve. Sounds good? Business problem?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So in the next slide, I have put this slide blank knowingly. So from your, I have kept it very generic because all of us use internet banking, right? So from your experience or your, common sense or your understanding of things, what all do you think can be done on this landscape or this perspective? You give your thoughts, I will just put it here.
Okay, sir. From the work context, I came to know that there's an issue. So what we can do is we can note the user activity.
Okay. So if you note the user activity, then what is that you are going to provide, or what is that you are going to enhance?
On his interest, like was he going to the bank statement of a year or yearly or monthly? According to that, I can display it in the home dashboard itself.
Okay. Note the user activity based on frequent, let's say, search or frequent interest, right? Frequent search or frequent interest.
Yes, sir.
Displayed on homepage, something like this, right?
Yes, sir.
That is one activity or one functionality that we can add. So this is not a full-fledged use case. So yeah, this is going towards building a use case. What is the use case? This is one kind of functionality addition, not a pure play analytics use case. Anything else, you know, extension of this?
We can log that history of that statements of the transactions done by the customer actually. Like phase one is the previous 3 or 6 months expenditure, right, through various modes, like different payment modes, like Google Pay or something like that, right? So we can make a future chart for his expenditure, like where he will be investing and expending the, where will be he's making the expenses, right? So that will help him like to take a preactive approach, like what are his future expenditures. So based on that, like he will know, right, okay, where I have to save actually. So that will be like a better prospect for the bank to get a hold of the customer.
Okay, so I'm writing based on historical transaction or behavior, forecast the future expense, and in some way assist customer in more saving or something like this. Okay, anything else? So both of you have given, so I will also give one use case here. What we can do is we can also improve the IVR experience. Okay, so what I mean by IVR experience is, suppose I go to ICICI Bank customer care, okay, and I call to ICICI Bank customer care saying, you know, my intent of calling is I want to know about any product. For example, if I have a car loan, so I want to know if I can do a full payment of my car loan at this point of time. Okay, so I am interested in car loan only. Okay, but what happens is when I call to ICICI Bank, right, they will tell me press option 1 for retail banking, option 2 for this banking, option 3 for corporate banking. Then they will say press 1 for credit card, 2 for debit card, 3 for something else, 4 for something else, 5 for something else, and 6 for car loan. And when I go in car loan, then again they will say select 1 for know the balance amount, select 2 for know the interest rate, something like that, right? So what I'm coming here to say is, suppose Aman as a user calls to the customer care, okay? So how can I improve the IVR experience or customer call experience? Okay, that is also one use case that is coming to my mind. If you have any other thing, I will put it here. Okay. Meanwhile, let me see if somebody is
trying. From the
above go example, ahead. Again,
from whatever the customer is asking, like as you said, he was asking about loan.
Hmm.
And from the client side, bank side, they were saying all the 1, 2, 3 options. Gone. So why can't we read his text, like the speech?
What text you're talking about?
The speech, sir, like he wants to know about the loan, and the yes. Bank will say all the 1 option, 2 option, 3 option, and the 6th option will be the loan.
Yes, correct.
Instead of all these options, you can take it directly into the loan option.
Yes, correct. But how do you do that? For example, you cannot make a rule-based system here, right? So I can call for car loan, Hasan can call for mutual fund, you can call for something, right?
Yes, sir.
So it cannot be a rule-based engine. For example, it cannot be something like everybody calls and direct everybody to credit card department. It cannot happen like that, right? Or it cannot also happen like some kind of rule. For example, if somebody's monthly average balance is this much, then route that person to credit card department. No. Rule-based engine is a no-no here. Okay, rules won't work. In this use case, third use case, rules won't work. That's what I think. If you have a different view, you are free to. This is a brainstorming, right? I can be wrong or I can be right also. You guys can be also wrong or right. Just from your experience, will rules work here or from your knowledge? Rules might not work here. That is what I am thinking. So out of these three use cases, we will take one use case and we will discuss. We cannot discuss all three use cases in limited amount of time. We will take one use case and we will discuss what are the different data elements. So if you see the next slide, right? Here we will come and we will select one use case and then we will discuss what kind of ML model we are talking about here. Unsupervised, supervised, semi-supervised, what kind of target variable, what kind of hypothesis, and what kind of data. So you guys tell me out of these three, which one shall we take?
Second one, sir, based on historical transaction, forecast the future expense.
Forecast the future expense, right? Hasan, yes, you agree with that?
Oh, yeah, I agree with that.
Okay, fine. So let's take the second use case, second one, and come to the next slide and we will discuss unsupervised, supervised, semi-supervised, what kind of learning will be or what kind of analysis it will be. So what kind of analysis it can be. So what we are trying to do here, we are trying to see the historical transaction of a customer and in some way, forecast is little biased. If we say forecast, it makes it little biased. So let's keep it like this. Based on historical transaction, assist customer in more saving or assist customer in more, better financial planning, you can say. Assist customer in more saving or better financial planning. Okay. So now tell me what kind of use case out of this we will solve. Will it be a kind of clustering or supervised? What can be your target variable in this case? If it's a supervised learning problem, then.
I'll keep it take linear regression and keep a threshold of if threshold seems exceeds.
Linear regression may what will be your target variable? Linear regression, we need a target variable, right?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So what is your target variable?
In a day, like how much expenses he is doing. Expense will be the target variable. In my sense.
Expense day wise, right? You are saying.
Yes, sir.
Day-wise expense, you are saying, right? So you are suggesting something like
yes.
This. New slide, insert a table, for example, three columns only. So this is your X1, this is your X2, and this is your target.
Yes.
Target. So you are saying on 1st of October, and some other, column, let's keep it some value here. Your expense is, let's say 30. And on 2nd October, some other features can be more, okay? And your target is nothing but expense, correct? So let's put here expense, okay? So now tell me what will be your X1, X2, etc. If this is the use case, we are not finalizing now, but if it is a use case, then what can be your X1, X2, etc.
X1 will be the dates obviously as you have written, and X2 will be the products of items he has gone, like he has expenditure items, how many in the quantity.
But tell me one thing, when you go to supermart, for example, or when you go to any shop, right? let's say Shoppers Stop or any shop. I'm in Bangalore, so I will say
okay.
Shoppers Stop or Koramangala, you go to Forum Mall. And I swipe my ICICI Bank card for 8,000 rupees, right? So for ICICI Bank, the information is 8,000 rupees swiped on the this merchant. Correct. But what I have bought is not there. Am I right? I have bought one shirt or I have bought two shoes. That information is not there. So how will you map that?
I will think and answer.
Yeah. Take your time. You got my problem statement, right?
Yes, sir. Sir.
So what maximum you can do is, what maximum you can do in my opinion is, here you can create A and here you can create X2 and you can add some columns, okay? So, for example, here in place of X2, I can also have another X3 and I can also have another column X4 and I can also have another column X5. Okay. And here X2, you can call, you know, expense on, for example, food. Okay. At least that information bank can map. And this can be on, let us say, entertainment. Getting it? One more, X3. And X4 is another expense which can be your investment, for example. X5 is another column which can be your loans. Okay. So, This mapping can be done because if it's a merchant is a food merchant or merchant is an entertainment merchant, if you are swiping in Book My Show, then Book My Show is an entertainment category, right?
Yes, sir.
So what I think is, I'm also thinking out loud here. If I create a data like this, will that make sense? Food entertainment this much, then the expense is this much. Yeah, I think it will make some sense because what is driving more to the expense that we will know, right?
Yes, sir.
Can we add like something like a feature as like mode of transaction, like means what is the payment mode like he is using? So like generally like people with good income, right, they generally used to have like coral and golden visa cards and whatnot. That can also be potential feature, right?
Yeah, we can keep that. Type of card you are saying, right?
Yeah.
Type of card. All these are features. People who are watching, don't confuse. These will come in different columns. We are just thinking out what kind of data is. So what kind of card you are using, what kind of places you are going, and what kind of transactions you are doing, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So suppose this is our data, just an example, okay. How important is date column here? Tell me from your learning of machine learning till now.
Like in weekends, generally people tend to have a more outgoing rate, like on Friday and all, right? And and then like festive seasons like Diwali and Holi, like they generally tend to have a huge expense rate actually as compared to normal days.
Yeah, true. And also if there is some holidays or some long weekend or some Christmas holidays, this kind of New Year kind of things, there will be more shopping. So more or less, if we fix this data, right, if we fix this data, then the next question comes. So we have decided our, this is a supervised learning problem and target variable we have decided, okay. Now, let us come to hypothesis. So data we have discussed more or less. Let us come to hypothesis now. So hypothesis is nothing but your assumptions or your understanding of the business problem. Okay. So for example, we now discussed, right? Hassan is telling that, and that's right also. people tend to spend more on weekends or holidays, etc. Okay. Next hypothesis can be, hypothesis is any assumption about the data. Okay. So what we are trying to do here is we are trying to see what is contributing more to the overall expense and if that is making sense. Okay. So for example, we can say if more expense in investment category, it's good or it's the green flag, we can say something like this. Similarly, we can say if expense in entertainment category, if more expense in entertainment category, it's not good, or we can say it's a yellow flag, something like this. And if more expense in your loan category, okay, it's not good as well, red flag. Now when I'm saying more expense in this category, means you have to understand if 30 rupees is the total expense, right, then you have to see how this 30 is splitting. Okay, the definition of more and less can be different customer by customer. Okay, more or less will differ. So for one person, more can be something else. For one person, if 30 rupees one person is spending, they can spend
based on his income.
Based on his income, but percentage we have to see how much is going in investment, how much is going in loan, how much is going in food, how much is going in entertainment. Like, so finally what we'll be interested in seeing is the coefficient of linear regression. True. Correct, na? So what can you tell me some more hypothesis about the data? Some more hypothesis that comes to your mind. Nothing is right or wrong in hypothesis. Data will tell the answer. Like whether our hypothesis is correct or not correct, data will tell.
Like a bank has some details like for ITR filings, maybe. So maybe like generally persons who pay like huge means income tax rate, they like tend to spend larger like expenditures yearly, like that, we can assume.
Okay, so more amount in tax filing. So that also goes as one of the independent variable in that case. More amount of tax filing means at least the person is above average income group, right? So we can categorize them as mid, low and high income group. So what we will do, we will take this tax filing in one column and then we can map. Okay, using Python, we can map in mid, low, high income group, right? And that can go as an input to the model. And we will see how mid income group is behaving, how low income group is behaving, how high income group is behaving. Yeah, good point. What else? Ganesh, anything from your side on this?
Yeah,
take your time. Not a problem, take your time.
Sir, anything like marriage functions or office personal marriage functions can be added to the expense spend?
That's one kind of anomaly. So if you see, that will be too much for one, you know, in 10 years, one time that will be there, right? So it can be treated as an anomaly, but a person cannot plan based on that, right? That's what my thought. So for example, if one child gets married for a person, that does not mean that after 2 years, one more child. It cannot be generalized. That's what I'm thinking.
Based on season, it will be like in summer season, like in some marriage seasons, it will be heavy use of expenditure. or else you can divide it as in summer he had most expense for cool drinks and all, for refrigerators and all, based on season.
Based on season, right? So season input, how we will take, we are thinking, and also in some season you are saying there can be more expense in one particular category.
Yes.
Okay. Yeah, that can be taken as input. Seasonal expense, take as input, and we can say intimate in advance, something like this. That this season is coming, right? So this kind of expense you can expect, something like that, right?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, cool. One more thing I will add here, something generic. So seventh number hypothesis, you are saying something, Ashan. Sorry, I could not enter that.
I'm saying like we can get some like personal data for that user, like designation, where he's working, like, and so that kind of data, like if we get, like we can able to get what is his ability like to make that expenses. Like,
okay, I got it. Personal data for user may impact the expense pattern. For example, if somebody is very young and you know just starting the job or kind of not married, single, then those kind of people might be more into entertainment and kind of things. On the other hand, people who have, you know, married and some kids, they can be more into investment kind of mindset or buying property kind of mindset, right? So that impact as well. So this is not a, you know, extensive list of hypotheses to the viewers, but just we are trying to give few indicative hypotheses that is very, very useful. I mean, see, we are sitting for just half an hour now and we are discussing many things, right? Business problem, data, hypothesis. So I'm just trying to give you a way of thinking, okay? This is not a complete list. There can be 70, 80 hypotheses like this. And there can be 70, once I define a hypothesis, right? There has to be a data element tagged with this hypothesis. For example, if I come to this sheet, right? Data category and data sources, I'm writing, there can be one more here, hypothesis number. So for example, hypothesis number one, if I take here, people tend to spend more on weekends and holidays, okay? What kind of data we might need here? So data category can be spend data. And data sources can be transaction, okay? Data sources can be sales. Data sources can be your purchase if they are storing in different systems. Similarly, if you take another hypothesis here, if more expense on entertainment category, it's not good, yellow flag, okay? So we need to know expense category. Data category can be expense type. To know the expense type, what we need merchant information. We need merchant complete information, if not possible, merchant category. We need merchant, all the information of merchant basically. Then we will also need transaction info. We will also need, when I say transaction info, it will be transaction location, etc. as well. Because maybe somebody, sometimes if I go out, then I tend to spend more. For example, if I go for a holiday, I may spend more. So location is also one thing that we can take. Transaction info, sales data, all these things are important. So any hypothesis if you take, right, seasonal expense, seasonal to know about this, then also we need expense data. So when I say seasonal, I need to capture the, what I need to capture, I need to capture if it's some kind of festival, right? So calendar data or, you know, festive data, festival data, so that I can map it, right? Festival data, holiday information in that particular geography, wherever we are talking about. Holiday information, okay? And we can also have here climate information. For example, in some kind of climate in European countries, you will see that if it's a very good climate, right, after the winter, if summers come, and if, you know, there is good sun, then people will kind of take holidays. So client information might also important, and sometimes it can also be your long weekends, if long weekends is there. So all these things will show some kind of patterns, right? You guys agree, right?
Sir, I agree, sir.
Right now. So just I'm taking different data categories. Why this is important to all the viewers and to you guys also? Why this is important? Because when you go and talk to business, right, then as a data scientist, you have to say what are the data elements that you need. So why I'm doing this brainstorming session is, I do not want you guys to start your use case from CSV. You are getting me, right? When you go to a training institute in data science, what they will give you? They will give you this.csv. What they will give you? They will give you cars.csv. What they will give you? They will give you Titanic data. Okay. I do not want you to think from CSV file point of view. Okay. I want you to think how this CSV is created. And that is why we are doing this session. Okay. So you will go to the business and you will say, as a data scientist, so tomorrow when you go to a company, right, in data science, it is highly possible that you will be directly exposed to business. Okay. You will, though you are a junior guy, but you know, you will be told to ask what data you need. And if you have these things in handy, right, so you can directly say, boss, I need transaction data. Give me all the tables which hold transaction data. Okay. I need merchant information. Do you have merchant information? ICICI Bank will say, we have merchant information, but maybe few things you need to take from the internet. So what is that internet taking thing? I will give you one example from my experience. Okay. So in USA, if you go, all the merchants are tagged to, let me tell you what is that. Just giving you some additional thing here that might make some sense. Okay. So for example, MACD, okay. And for example, ABC Hospital. Okay. And for example, ABC Lodging Booking, ABC Hotel, let's say Hilton Hotel, just an example I'm giving. Hilton Hotel. And another example can be your ABC Travels. Okay. All these are different organizations in different categories, right? Now in this MACD category, I can put KFC and I can put Burger King. I don't know if it is there in US, but just I'm putting. Here I'm saying ABC XYZ Hospital. Okay. I'm saying RTZ Baby Care. Okay. Hilton Hotel, another hotel, ABC Travels, another travel. So if you go to internet, find the merchant mapping, right? It's not, you know, a secret thing. So there is a common merchant mapping in USA. For example, all these food guys, right, will be called as 05. Just an example. All the hospital guys or baby care or any type of these guys will be called 09. All these hotel guys will be called as 11. Just an example, okay? All these tours, travels, all these guys will be called as 15. So in their financial system, these kind of mappings are there. Now, when I want to see my merchant information, then is ICICI Bank or HDFC Bank storing this merchant information, or I need to take some element from the internet or, you know, open government sites or somewhere. So those things you have to take care of here in merchant information, merchant category, transaction information, and because you will be creating your own CSV, okay? If somebody else creates a CSV and give it to you, nothing like that. I mean, your work is saved, your hard work is saved, but I want all of you to be prepared to create this, okay? I do not want you to be surprised, or I do not want you to be in a mindset that somebody else will create and give it to you, like you are getting from Kaggle or getting from different data science learning platforms. So you come here, you identify different data sources, and then you ask your business, I need these data sources. For example, if you say festive data, this data is easily available on Google, right? So you go and search big festivals in India, you will get that data. So it depends climate information. I think this you need to take from climate website or somewhere. So you need to think where from you are trying to take all these data. Once you have the data, then you prepare a master data, right?
Actually, I wanted to add one thing on that data sources part. Like, if it's like some gateways like Paytm and all, like they provide various discounts through this debit card and all, right, for ICICI and HDFC. So that can also be part of a data source, like because we will have both the information, like purchase information and like what is the mode and basically
what is the mode. So you are saying one more independent feature here we can add.
Yeah, I mean, in the, from the perspective of the data sources.
Okay, from the perspective of data sources, you are saying. Yeah. We can get that. Even we have access to that data. Platform of purchase or something, right? And then from these guys, for example, from Paytm or from Google Pay, we can have. But I still think that this is an individual data. For example, my Google Pay transactions, Google will know and I will know. How a third party will know. Similarly, my Paytm transactions. Paytm will know and I will know. I'm just thinking out loud here. What is the meaning of that? So yeah, that's a good point. We can see and take that. But I hope you guys are getting what I'm telling in data and data sources, right? Very, very important these things. What category of data you need, what types of data you need, what type of tables you need, because you cannot go 100 times and tell, you know, I need this also, I need that also, give me this also, give me that also. Create an extensive list, and in first meeting only you tell I need all these things. When can you give me access to all these things? Because these things are time taking things. And once you get your data, something like this, right? I am creating a, you know, some simple data here. There can be 100, 500 columns, we don't know. Then expense column. This is a regression problem. Now, what kind of machine learning algorithms we will use and why? So we know this is a regression problem. What algorithms to use and why? Any inputs on this, guys?
Logistics will help, I think, so, from my perspective.
That's a classification thing.
Yes, sir, so we can add that also, sir. Like, based on some threshold point, if it exceeds, we can warn them that he's using more.
Okay. In linear regression, can we use linear regression? Or can we use some kind of ensemble technique or deep learning technique? What will make more sense here? What do you think will make more sense here?
Like if you go with the linear regression, like linear regression assumes like features, like here we have more of like dependent features, like there will be some thing like multicollinearity between the features, like, right?
Mm-hmm.
So maybe we can go with the like ensemble techniques, like decision tree or random forest as a baseline model.
Okay. What we are trying to do here is, let's go back to the problem statement one more time, okay? What we are trying to do here is, we are trying to, for a bank, we are trying to understand, okay, this is not the use case. User experience we started with, but we went to, that is fine, in historical transaction, assist customer in more saving, better financial planning, okay? So what we need to tell to the customer is, you know what? You are spending in entertainment too much. So if your entertainment expense come down, then you will be able to save more. Okay. And when I say entertainment expense is more, that means that entertainment is driving more to the total expense. Okay. And when I say that, they also have to understand how much it is driving to. Okay. And when I say how much it is driving to, then it is all about coefficients. And when it's about coefficient, then we have to go for a regression based model. Am I making sense here?
Yes.
Okay,
sir.
You got it right. So I want to tell to Hassan that, Hassan, you know, your total expense is this much, but you know what? Entertainment is contributing more to your expense. So why can't you reduce that little bit? When I say more, it has to be coefficient. So let us take linear regression for an example. Now, if I take linear regression, then there can be many versions of that. Okay. Linear regression, we know there are a few things to take care, for example, normality and these things. But still, I feel in these type of problems, right, you will have to force some kind of regularization like L1, L2 regression. Okay, the reason for that is some of these variables might not make sense at all. So in some categories, there may be very less relation with the target, probably. And 3-4 categories will only, you know, contribute more. So what I feel is some kind of linear regression baseline we can start. And then we can go to the some kind of regularization, L1, L2 kind of stuff. And we can finalize one model. Like this is the model, these are the coefficients. And one more thing is coming to my mind is like Hassan or Ganesh, somebody was making the point, right? The expense patterns will be different. Okay. So for example, for a young person, it can be different. For a middle-aged person, it can be different. Or for a little old person, it can be different. What we can do now, before fitting linear regression model, let us break the data in 3 buckets and then fit 3 different models, because we cannot treat all these guys as same, right? So either we can break on the age group, 3 different buckets, and we can do 3 different analysis, or we can do a clustering in the beginning based on many features. Clustering on the beginning based on many features, and whichever guys come on one cluster, let us train one model for those guys, whichever another cluster, one model on those guys. And when we do prediction, then we pass this through this cluster and then do the prediction. Are you connecting with this idea?
Yes, sir.
Okay. And we can also go ahead with some other algorithms like Hassan suggested, this one, your random forest or ensemble. The only problem is we will not be able to estimate the impact of independent on the target. Okay. So that also we can try if we are getting very good accuracy or something. But these are few of the things we can do. So this is where I think we have covered most of the thing, right? From business problem to data sources, to your hypothesis, to your how your sample data will look like. I gave you some example of merchant mapping and some example of why I'm doing these sessions, right? And some kind of hypothesis data, everything we have discussed, some kind of what kind of model we can use, right? So how did you like this session, Hassan and Ganesh? Did you learn something? If you learn something, then this is useful.
Yes, sir, it was very useful for me, sir. I've learned how to compensate the, how to think like data science, like how to write it, everything, the problem statement and all. I've learned from this session, sir.
Okay. Hassan, was it useful to you also?
Yes, I mean, actually, like, I got to know like how to approach a business use case and how to go about like the thought process.
Thought process is important. Yeah, that's what I keep telling always. There is nothing right or wrong. Whatever we are discussing, somebody can come and say me that this point is not right. I will agree that maybe something is not right. But you know, that improving that thought process, improving that common sense to approach a problem is what is, you know, objective of these videos. Okay. So thanks one more time, you both, for joining and giving your time, guys. And thanks everyone for watching also. Keep watching the videos. And if you want to participate in these sessions, I will give the link in the description. Okay. So thanks, Hasan. Thanks, Ganesh. Have a good rest of the night.
Thank you.
Thanks.